second basket of the game. Well, Phoenix played a seven-game homestand all against Eastern teams. Booker with a floater.
This is just standard floppy to get Book the ball. You can see he turns it. You can just see right now, obviously, an elite player like Book comes off the screen. It's going to draw a lot of attention. Frank spaces a little bit, makes some indecision for his defender. Do I help? Do I get back to my man? Mikal Bridges is going off the other side to create better spacing on the weak side, and Book can get to his spot for an easy shot.
As he makes his Brooklyn Nets debut, Shamit in the corner, connects!
Right now, as the defender goes over the screen, he just fades and watch Landry's footwork, where he hits his left foot down first to get into his shot before the ball gets there, obviously so the defender cannot recover. Bang, bang, good shot, defender is late.
Lost a lot of games here against the Lakers over the years. Haven't won in this venue since 2017, but this is, oh, up top, nice feed, Booker.
You can see Book gets to the baseline, everybody gets to their spacing, comes off the screen. Now Harrell takes a step up, now coming off the five. The moment Harrell steps up, DA's at the rim, it's just an easy lob. You can also see where Morris helped off Bridges, so not only did he have the lob at the rim, he had Mikhail in the corner. Again, proper spacing. You can see this, it's very good spacing. You can see that Chris Paul is so far high, it takes away the stunt from Schroeder. You can see Schroeder's late, and now you're at the party at the rim.
Lou curls, catches, and connects. Ask and you shall receive.
Here's Floppy from the baseline. One of the most important things for this play is Kennard hitting the paint. You can see Ed Davis is in help position because of the rim. Zubac gets a good screen, and Williams comes off free.
Baines throwing it down.
Powell in the paint, up fake, and then banks it in.
Here is an away. It's just a staggered screen on the side, and there's a lot of options you can do from this. Norman Powell, very good at it, getting to his right hand. He catch curls and goes and gets to the rim. Aaron Baines does a great job at diving, and now you make Karl Anthony Towns have some indecision on where do I go? Do I go to the ball? Do I go to back to my man? It's a good screen by Baines, allowing Norman to get all the way to the rim.
These particular guys played extremely well. We gave all the credit to Chris Paul, but it was some other guys as Tim Hardaway Jr. knocks down the three-pointer.
Very good play for a shooter. The shooter's now in the second position, and James Johnson curls the first one and pins Hardaway in for the easy shot for the shooter.
Go outside of himself as a player, pretty strong defender.
Soft touch, Herter.
Atlanta loves to do this, it actually turns into some floppy. Same thing, Kevin curls it, brings the second guy back out, and then the shooter comes back off. Same thing as a floppy action, just a different way to get into the pin down action.
Jim, he's got a chance to make history here tonight as Jimmy Butler answers right back.
Jimmy Butler, obviously very good, talented scorer, driver. You have the shooter coming off, and Duncan Robinson is obviously going to draw a lot of attention. Butler makes a pass and then gets away, and as Josh Okogie stunts, he gets the ball back to drive it. It's a very important part of off-ball screening is getting the ball back to the passer after his man stunts for the shooter.
Kuzma off the screen. Every time the Lakers range, it crept a little bit close. There's a feed inside, a good one too.
This is a great job of continuing to play in the action with great spacing. Kuzma comes off, doesn't have it. Clippers do a good job, now he backs it up. You can see in the proper spacing, Morris is over here in the right-hand corner, keeping Kawhi Leonard spaced out. and because of the thrust and how hard Kuzma cuts, the proper spacing allows him to get this layup by Morris and by Horton Tucker, which Lou Williams is guarding in front of the Clippers bench. Again, great spacing.
He's doing the head coach and also the credentials he brings from his playing career.
The refs reviewed the previous foul by Minnesota to see if it was a clear pass foul. They ruled it was a common foul as Kyrie Irving.
This is another in a way action. This comes off for the shooter and Harris doesn't have it. You can see how open the floor is and now they're going to play games. Harris can go to the corner and split, or he can go to the top and split and create some indecision. Obviously, you have to go over the top with Harris because of his shooting ability. And because of the pace and how hard Harris cuts, he brings the defender. Now Kyrie can come play at the top.
And all of a sudden, the game gets really interesting and they step up.
Hardaway Jr. on the three-point connection.
Having his best year.
Okay, Dallas has always done a good job with off-ball screenings. This is kind of going back to the floppy, but they do it on the side. This is Tim Hardaway Jr. He can play floppy, go off the baseline, or he can go off the top. If he goes off the top, he'll play. He can play high pick and roll. Obviously, he's going to come off looking for shot first, or he can play with Kleber right there at the top. And the, or if he comes off the baseline, if he comes off Porzingis, they will flare Doncic at the top and let him come off an off-ball screen. Flares are a very important screen in off-ball just because guys' ability to shoot and to open the floor. So you see Hardaway comes off the top, wide open for a shot.
14 points now for Drew Holiday. Drew Holiday with four assists. Doncic, he's got Powell, man, he's going to the line looking for the three-point play.
He comes and it comes back off, and now they hit the flare for Doncic, slip, and Dwight Powell has it. You can just see all the options. Good spacing here. Dwight Powell sets a good flare to make the defender go over the top and then slips. And again, great spacing. Look at the corner. If Dwight doesn't have the layup, he has the kick out three.
It's just good offense.
Yeah, Juan Toscano-Anderson is at the scorer's table. Draymond's coming out at the next stoppage. Catch and shoot. Man, McCollum looked down, still made it.
This is the first screen that you have. It's just a pin down, and they're going to flip it back to Lillard. You have a flare, which obviously they throw to CJ, or on the opposite side, they have a pin down. So you can see Draymond under the basket. He reads it well, but it takes away the help on both sides. It's still a floppy action on one side and a flare on the other. Floppy on one side, flare on the other. Obviously, an elite shooter can come off either screen.
And he's guarding Lillard. 8-0 Laker run. Nurkic will get it right back from McCollum.
CJ off a flare. And if you don't have it, then they just come right back to him. The weak side is spaced. And the weak side had to get out of the paint, cleanse himself, and they're late for the help.